Okay, now we're buttoning up, getting ready for the pour, doing the odds and ends. You'll notice that the bracing is put on horizontally rather than vertically. There's not going to be a lot of movement in a 2.5 course wall, so it's put on that way with a turnbuckle on each end to allow them to bring the wall in and out just minutely to keep that wall dead straight. As you can see now that the vertical joints, stack joints, have been filled and have a strapping across them to give them strength till the pour is finished. After the concrete is set, then the strapping would come off and they would continue on with waterproofing or backfill. So, and he's also filling in little odds and ends for our carrier footings that basically are just filling in between the wall, giving them some support and having it do the whole trick. So we're getting very close to being ready to pour. Now what you notice here, we've got another slip joint or a vertical joint here that we filled in. So we're keeping everything on our chalk lines. The bracing is in again. This is a foundation and the actual floor for this level is going to be poured up on top of here. So we don't have a problem right now with our floor system, but if we're going to do a floor up above, we're going to do, if our floor didn't come 4 inches above here, it we're going to be say flush with this. We want to make sure that we allow the cutouts for our doors. We want to know where they're at because it's very hard if we get concrete above the doorway to clean it out. And it's always nice to have a little room to work with. A lot of times we can finish it direct and put a plate under it for a thermal break, a 2x12 on top of where that door is going to set rather than concrete.